One of the things I've learned in doing this kind of surgery for 10 years, and I jokingly refer to myself as a surgical MacGyver, and the issue being that you really have to improvise a lot to provide quality care for the patients. And how can you save these people's lives with limited resources? Oftentimes, I'm asked by people what I need to do to prepare and what to bring along with me. And really, I don't bring a lot of supplies and equipment. I like to work with what the local surgeons and health facility has so that we can figure out how to make things better. One thing that I do like to have with me, though, is the old Nokia candy bar cell phone. The reason I like it, well, one, it's cheap and I can get a SIM card locally, but it has the flashlight. And I can't tell you the number of times that the lights have gone out, someone's been able to fish it out of a pocket, turn it on, and we've been able to at least control the situation or finish an operation before the lights come back on. It was really amazing for me to see how a lot of surgical care is delivered in many of these places. If someone maybe has appendicitis or needs a cesarean section, their family transports them to the hospital. If they're lucky enough to have somebody qualified to take care of them, they have to provide the supplies themselves. And what I mean by that is the doctor will write a prescription for sterile gloves, suture, gauze, antibiotics. Then the family has to take that prescription, go outside the hospital to a private pharmacy, pay for and buy the supplies, and then bring them back and give them to the doctor before care is given. After having done this for a number of years, I realized that maybe the best way to approach things was to really work with the local surgeons and try to develop their infrastructure and capacity. What we found is that really, in order to take care of the population, they need their own surgeons. And so started working with them to develop a residency training program to teach the guys that would stay locally, who understand the conditions, who understand the culture and the language, which is really important. Much fun as I have going over there, and as much fun as they seem to have hosting me, it's really up to them to really move things forward. These pictures were taken in Sierra Leone in 2009, and I really liked them because I think they show the potential, and they're not the normal signs of desperation. You look at the people, and they're just wonderful people. What was also interesting about when we had Susan Hale Thomas with us taking the photos, the administrator asked her one day, well, what are you going to do with these photos? And she was a little hesitant, and she and I discussed it, and we realized that these photos actually belong to the people of Sierra Leone. So what we did was we put them on a CD, we delivered them to the hospital, we also delivered them to the Ministry of Health, and set up a meeting where they could present it, and we showed a video to the media. It was really a great example of collaboration where we had some external technology and expertise, but we were able to really share it with the local community.